Episode 7. We're at number 122. Love You Too is number 122. It's from Revolver or also from Yesterday and Today. This is the famous Butcher cover, which was of course a band. It's the first Indian song, the first true sitar song. Of course, there was Norwegian Wood on Rubber Soul, but that was more like a gimmick on a John Lennon song. But Love You Too is the first real heavy Indian Ravi Shankar influenced Beatles and George Harrison song. I like it. Number 121 is She Came In Through the Bathroom Window from Abbey Road, from the medley again. I think it's a very good song, but since it's just a part of the medley, it's not really a worked out real song. I think it could be higher if it were like a real 3 minute pop song. It's one of the first lyrics by Paul about Linda. And it's a very good song. I think it was one of the favorite songs of George Harrison from Abbey Road. There's an interview with George from, I think, October 1969, when at the time when he wasn't really good friends with Paul anymore, but he still praised that song, which is, I think, remarkable at that time. Number 120 is by George. Sapphire Truffle, and I just talked about George not being good friends with Paul anymore. Well, this is the first, maybe the first Beatles song ever where a Beatle has a dig at another Beatle. There's the line, what is the line in, I think, in the second verse? We all know obla di bla da, but can you tell me where you are? Which, of course, is George having a dig at Paul. The rest of the song is more funny or more lightweight because it's about Eric Clapton's addiction to chocolate and candies. So there's also the line, "You have to have your teeth pulled out," which is like, Eric, if you eat so much chocolate, you have to go to the dentist and you will have to have your teeth pulled out. So lightweight song at a dark time. The next one is number again, George Harrison. This is the episode 7 is the George Harrison episode. 119, I Want to Tell You from Revolver. I never heard an early version of it. I don't think there are many bootlegs of it, but it's widely known that it wasn't really a very good song, and that Paul McCartney rearranged that song. The intro, the outro, all those little bits are supposedly ideas of from Paul, but it makes the song really a good song. Number 118 is I'm Looking Through You from Rubber Soul, mainly a Paul McCartney song about Jane Asher. You know, that was the start of Paul having, not being satisfied anymore with the relationship to Jane. I think at that time he suspected that she's having an affair with a fellow actor when she was doing a play in Bristol, and Paul had suspicions that she had an affair with him, and that song, I'm Looking Through You, is about that. The one interesting thing about it is that on the American version of Rubber Soul, it's a different mix. There's even a false start left in at the beginning. You know, in the American version, they start the song and then it falls apart and they have to start again, which probably was an accident by Capitol Records, by the American label. Interesting version. Number 117 is, whoa, again, George Harrison. So now we had four George Harrison songs in a row. You know, that's not on purpose. That's how it came out. Really? It's Think for Yourself. The most interesting thing about Think for Yourself, I think I've talked about it in a previous episode. You have to check out on YouTube if it's still on there, the recording session of Think for Yourself. This is the bootleg. This is the recording session where we have most footage of. There's like a 40-minute bit of the recording of the song, which is great, which is a Beatle fan dream come true. Very funny, where John Lennon always gets the background vocals wrong, and it's kind of funny how they react to that. You have to check that out. Number 116 is Good Day Sunshine, also from Revolver, from Paul McCartney. I've read Beatles ranking list online, and it was the worst Beatles song ever according to that list. I can't understand that there are much worse songs. Now number 115, we're in a territory. All those songs are almost classics, or not almost. Those are classics. I think "Good Day Sunshine" is a classic. Now we're talking about almost perfect pop songs. So I can't understand how they could put that song in the last place. It's a great pop song in my opinion. Number 115. So "Good Day Sunshine" was 116. 115 is "Hello Goodbye." It's a bit like "Good Day Sunshine" Part 2. It's a bit similar. It's also very optimistic, Paul McCartney, sunny pop song. And the outro probably was like a precursor to the "Hey Jude," to the iconic "Hey Jude" outro. That's the first time he tried something like that. The video, I really love the music video with Paul and John dancing. Great song in my opinion. 114 is "And Your Bird Can Sing" from Revolver. It's allegedly about Marianne Faithfull. In Liverpool, Northern England, bird refers to a girl, which is maybe nowadays not that PC anymore. But "And Your Bird Can Sing" is John Lennon probably talking to Mick Jagger, about Mick Jagger bragging about his girlfriend, Marianne Faithfull, who could sing. Number 113 is "For No One." I think in most other lists, this is way up higher. This is at least in the top 100. At the beginning, in episode one, I told you don't take the positions that serious. Now that I'm looking at it, that's a bit low for that song. It's really a classic. It's a great song, but you will see. Now all the songs are really brilliant. It's difficult to rank those songs. "For No One," classic Paul McCartney ballad, great song. 112 is "Old Brown Shoe." Again, George Harrison. So I think we had five or six George. I think George Harrison had like a total of 20 songs in the Beatles, and five, six, or seven of the songs are in episode seven. That's a bit strange. "Old Brown Shoe," B-side of "Ballad of John and Yoko," great song, great slide guitar. Probably one of the first times George played this kind of what would become his trademark, that slide guitar. In his solo career, he was famous for playing slide guitar. I think this is one of the first times he tried that, and it's a very good song. Funny lyrics, once more. 111, another classic, "All My Loving." This is maybe for like 70-year-old Americans, one of their memories of the Beatles, one of the most significant memories of the Beatles, because it was the first song the Beatles played on American TV, in that Sullivan show. Great song, and like I said in episode one, Paul McCartney often had those kind of letter songs, and this is one of those great early Beatles song. 110 is Can't Buy Me Love from the same, almost the same era. It was the single after that, you know, in February they played, February 64 they played the Ed Sullivan Show. This was the single that was released in March or April 64. And I think this was the single that was number one in the week in April 1964 when they had all five top positions in the American charts, which was the best charts week ever by anyone. And Can't Buy Me Love was number one in that week. Next 109 is Misery. From the first album, one of my favorite songs from Please Please Me. I think it's probably influenced by Del Shannon, which was a quite successful pop singer in the early 60s. It's a bit in that style, and it's a great John Lennon song. Yeah, that's the very George Harrison heavy. That was the very George Harrison heavy episode 7. Thank you for watching.